This is a demonstration of how to complete the pause and practice projects using the SIMbook in SIMnet. The pause and practice projects are throughout each chapter in the In Practice series, and they're anywhere from 3 to 5 pause and practice projects per chapter, and all of these build on each other. The first thing that you want to do is navigate to the SIMbook in SIMnet where the pause and practice projects are located. So I'm going to go into Word Chapter 1. Click on the SIMbook, and I can either open the SIMbook or I could go directly to the pause and practice projects. I'm going to go ahead and open up the SIMbook, click the table of contents, and then go to pause and practice Word 1-1, which is the first one in this chapter. If a data file is needed, it will show up in this area. This particular pause and practice project starts with a blank document. But if a data file is needed for the project, it will show up in this area. You will work in the live application and open a new document, follow the instructions, and work your way through. These are guided projects that give detailed instructions on what to do and how to do it. Plenty of screenshots are used to help you along the way. As you complete the projects in the live application and go through and do all the instructions here at the end, it will ask you to save it. At the beginning, it tells you what to save it as. Your instructor may give you a different file name to save it as. Once the first pause and practice is complete, you'll save it and close it and move on to the next pause and practice. You can navigate to the next pause and practice by clicking the table of contents icon and selecting the next pause and practice. It's going to have you open up your previous pause and practice. Read the instructions carefully here. As you begin working on the next pause and practice project, it will ask you to save that project with a different file name. If there are data files needed, they will be included here as a link, which you can click on and it will download to your computer that you can use. Continue following the instructions on this pause and practice. Then you can go save the document at the end. You can go on to the next pause and practice, which will open, and you'll use the file from the previous pause and practice. These files build on each other, and follow the instructions until you finish. When you have finished the pause and practice for all the pause and practices in the chapter, save the file and close it, and then you will send it to your instructor, or your instructor will give you specific instructions on how to get that file to them. In my class, you will email it to me. Just the final project, the one that's listed in the syllabus. And that's it.